Hi guys, welcome to our channel Shubhada Group of Education Sirsi. You are watching Satish Sir's physics videos for Karnataka CET and NEET. Look at the problem. The angle between dipole moment and the electric field at any point on the equatorial line is okay. See here. So while studying the concepts of electric field due to a dipole, you have studied that you have taken plus Q charge separated by the minus Q charge, that is what constitutes a dipole by a distance of 2a, correct? Clearly we have taken the dipole moment as from minus Q charge to positive charge, correct? That is what vector P, that is what we have taken. But the electric field at any point on the equatorial line, that is the case at that time, what we have discussed it, suppose if it is plus Q charge and if it is minus Q charge like this, then if this is what the perpendicular bisector at this point, we got resultant electric field like this, correct? In the sense, electric field is in this direction as well as the dipole moment is in this direction, correct? Dipole P. In the sense, what is the angle between them? The angle between them is how much? 180 degrees. So that's the reason why option D is the right answer for this particular question. Very good conceptual question. I hope that you have understood the method that we have used here. Look at the next problem. 4 into 10 to the power of 10 electrons are removed from a neutral metal sphere of diameter 20 cm placed in air. The magnitude of the electric field at a distance of 20 cm from the center is the question, correct? Suppose if it is a sphere like this, and from here it is 4 into 10 to the power of 10 electrons are removed, correct? If the electrons are removed at that time, this body is positively charged now. Okay, so what is the number of the charges there? Q is equal to plus or minus Ne. So the N is 4 into 10 to the power of 10 electrons and charge is 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulomb. So that will give you 6.4 into 10 to the power of how much it is? Minus 9 coulomb charge. So now from the center, you need to find out the value of the electric field at a distance of 20 cm, correct, at this point. So therefore, electric field due to a spherical shell is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into charge divided by distance square. That the distance should be taken from the center, okay. So therefore, E is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q is how much? 6.4 into 10 to the power of minus 9 divided by R is 20 centimeter, 20 into 10 to the power of minus 2 square. Substitute the value of 9 into 10 to the power of 9 as 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, so that you will get it as the answer of 1440 newton per coulomb. So that's the reason why option D is the right answer for this particular question. Move to the next question. If there are only one type of the charge in the universe, okay, then which of the following is the correct? So the closed integral of EDS is equal to 0 if the charge is outside, and EDS is equal to Q by epsilon times that is what if the charge is inside. So it is a question of Gauss law. So that's the reason why if the charge is outside the any surface, okay, at that time, suppose if the charge is present somewhere here, at that time there is no electric field, electric field is going to be 0. Suppose the charge is inside the closed loop, at that time the closed integral of electric field, that must be equal to 1 by epsilon naught times the charge enclosed by that particular loop. So that's the reason why option A is the right answer for this one. This is the law of Gauss, okay, or the Gauss law in electrostatics. So that's the reason why option A is the right answer for this particular question. Okay, so thank you very much for watching this video. I will definitely upload some more problems on KCET as well as NEET in future. Kindly share this video with your friends. Please do subscribe and like the our video. Suppose if you have any doubts, just mention your doubts in the comment box so that I can help you with. Thank you very much. Wish you all the best.